What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel and to week one of my Overwatch League Stage 3 key matches. I can't believe it's already been over a month since the last time I did one of these. It feels really good and refreshing to bring it back. I'm sure that many of you are new to this series, so let me give a quick explanation as to how these types of videos work. So basically, what I do is pick out games that I recommend watching every single week. I usually give a brief explanation as to why I feel said game is important and give my score predictions as well. And that's pretty much it. But before I dive into the Thursday matchups, I thought I'd help set the scene for Stage 3 by telling you some important info that's worth knowing about. First off, the format of Stage 3 will be very similar to Stages 1 and 2. All 20 teams will play 7 games, with the 8 best qualifying for the stage playoffs, and the winners of each division earning the 1 and 2 seeds. In terms of the format of the stage playoffs, well, the quarterfinals matchups will be the first to 3 map wins, and both the semifinals and grand finals will be the first to 4. The prize pool will also be the exact same, with the winners receiving 200k, and every other team receiving 25k at the minimum. There are some things that are different about this stage though. For one, the map pool will be a bit different compared to previous stages. Take a look for yourself. The feature control maps will be Ilios, Oasis, and Nepal. On Assault, you'll see Paris, Volskaya Industries, and Horizon Lunar Colony. Hybrid will be Hollywood, Eichenwald, and Numbani. And finally on Escort, you're going to see Havana, Watchpoint Gibraltar, and Dorado. The one map that really stands out to me is obviously Havana. It's a fairly new map, and it'll be the first time we ever get to see it played in the Overwatch League. The other noticeable difference about the stage compared to the previous ones is the patch. Stage 3 will be played on patch 1.36, which unfortunately means that GOATs is still going to be the most powerful comp in the game. Prepare yourselves to strap in for another stage full of GOATs, everybody. It is not going anywhere. And I think that pretty much covers everything I wanted to inform you of, so without wasting any more time, let's take a look at my key matches for Thursday night. There are three in particular that could potentially hold a fair amount of value entertainment-wise. The first game you should consider tuning in for is the Seoul and Florida game. Yes, this game seems like a blowout on paper, but it's going to be interesting since this will be Fate's first game with the Mayhem. He will surely be a big upgrade over Swan, and seeing how he does in his debut has definitely caught my eye. This will be his first game not playing for the Valiant or the Immortals organization since 2017. The Dynasty are also looking to take advantage of what appears to be an easy win on the schedule to try and improve their chances of getting back into the stage playoffs after missing it during Stage 2. As mentioned earlier, there's a good chance this game is not very close, which is the exact reason why I'm picking the Dynasty to win it 4-0. Even if Fate improves the team, the lineup as a whole is kind of weak compared to a team like Seoul. Game number 2 that I recommend watching is the Chengdu Hunters versus the Guangzhou Charge. I feel like this game will be good for a few different reasons. For one, this is a rematch of their Stage 1 showdown. The last time these two faced off, the Hunters won a close 5-map set. It's going to be interesting to see if they can prevail once again, or if the Charge are the ones to win this time. Starting off the stage with a win would be great for either one of these teams. The Charge want to remove that sour taste of defeat from their mouths after a brutal 2-5 Stage 2, and the Hunters just came off of a tough loss to the Valiant that would have put them in the playoffs if they won. I think it's also worth noting that both of these teams enjoy running DPS comps, so we could see triple DPS Wrecking Ball strats from both sides, kind of like with their Stage 1 game. The Charge have also been experimenting a lot with the Doomfist Goats comp lately, so that is another excitement factor to look out for. If I were to predict who I think is going to win this game, then I would have to go with the Hunters 3-1. I think the Charge will put up a decent fight, but I feel like Chengdu is extra motivated to make the playoffs after coming so close in Stage 2. I wouldn't be too surprised if the Charge came out on top though. These teams match up pretty well with one another, so it could go either way for sure. The other game I recommend watching is the one between the Valiant and Dragons. Both of these teams came off a stage where they showed improvement. Shanghai made the playoffs and even took a map off the Shock, and the Valiant were able to go 3-4 after an abysmal Stage 1. The Dragons in particular have a somewhat easy schedule, so it's going to be crucial for them to take advantage of winnable games such as this one to ensure that they make the Stage 3 playoffs. The interest factor is most certainly there for the Valiant as well. This will be their first game without Fate, and with the three players they got in return for trading him. Fact Fiction will most likely be the starting main tank for the Valiant in this game, so it's going to be interesting to see how he does. There's also the chance that we see Shax and McGravy, so be on the lookout for them as well. While I am intrigued by the Valiant's new looking roster, I will find it hard to believe that they can be a threat until I see some evidence otherwise. I think it's going to take a few games for this team to really find an identity for themselves. I also think that Shanghai is only continuing to get better, which is the exact reason why I am picking the Dragons to win this game 3-1. That's all I have to say about Thursday, so moving on to Friday, game number 1 to look out for is the Boston Uprising versus the London Spitfire. I've mentioned this before here on the channel, but these guys had some real close matches in the past, so this is kind of a rivalry game in the way. But that's not the only reason to look out for this game. The Spitfire had a solid stage too, and will be looking to stay consistent by having yet another strong stage. The Uprising, on the other hand, were struggling, so I'm sure that they'll be looking to bounce back by starting their stage off with a big win against a good team. I feel like Boston usually plays their best Overwatch when people start to doubt what they're capable of, and since they've gone through a lot of ups and downs so far, some fans and teams may not take this team seriously enough. Because of this, and London having a history of being inconsistent, I've decided to pick the Uprising to win this game 3-2. Yeah, Yes, I'm very aware that this is a pretty bold prediction that could very easily be wrong, especially because London just beat them during Stage 2, but I just have this gut feeling that Boston is going to push London to their limits. The other match I recommend watching on Friday night is the final game between the Dallas Fuel and LA Gladiators. These two teams are coming off of a playoff appearance, and I would say that both of them are in a pretty good position to do so again in Stage 3, which means that this might not be the last time we see these two play each other. I would say that these teams appear to be pretty evenly matched in terms of skill. This match has Game of the Week potential written all over it. Definitely look out for the battle between OGE and Roar as well as Void and Note. There's a good chance that the outcome of this game depends on which pair has the better day. Because I believe both teams match up pretty well with one another, I predict that the Gladiators will win 3-2 in what will hopefully be a 5-map thriller that every fan of the league will enjoy. Up next, we have the Saturday matches, and there's only one in particular that really stands out for me. The Philadelphia Fusion versus the Hangzhou Spark is the one game that I think is 100% worth tuning in for. The Spark came off a 5-2 stage where they only lost to the Shock and Titans, and the Fusion managed to go 3-4 even with one of the tougher schedules in the league. Both teams have an 8-6 record, so the outcome of this game could affect the overall playoff implications later down the line. I also think this means we could be in for a pretty close game. Other than the main tank department, both teams match up pretty well with one another. The Spark definitely have the edge since Gushui's a far better tank than Sato, but it's hard to count the Fusion out. Kind of like with the Uprising, this team tends to perform better when they're the underdog that people start to write off. My brain is telling me to pick the Spark because they have the main tank advantage, but my heart is saying the Fusion will win. This one is definitely a toss-up, but I'm going with the Fusion 3-1. I think this game more than likely comes down to which support line has the better day, and whether or not Sato feeds. Something tells me that Boombox, Neptuno, and EQR are going to have a good day, and that Sato plays well enough to not bring his entire team down. Now we finally have Sunday, and there's two games in particular that I feel are worth paying attention to, one of which is the London Spitfire and NYXL matchup. Do I even need to explain myself with this one? This is one of the biggest rivalries we have in the Overwatch League. The history of it stretches all the way back to Stage 1 in 2018. These teams have played some classics, and I look forward to seeing them renew the rivalry. However, right now I think the NYXL are the stronger team. They're better suited and more consistent in the current meta. Also, as I mentioned before, the Spitfire tend to have a history of being inconsistent on a stage-to-stage basis, and since they did well in Stage 2, I feel like they're overdue to struggle a little bit, which is the exact reason why I believe New York will win this game 3-1. Look out for Mono versus Gesture and Prophet versus Nene. I feel like this game comes down to who wins the Reinhardt and Zarya battles. And last, but certainly not least, the final key match of Week 1 is the Vancouver Titans versus the LA Gladiators. The Titans just came off a heartbreaking loss to the Shock in the Stage 2 finals, and I'm interested to see how they bounce back from it. For those of you who don't know, Runaway, aka the team that would end up becoming the Titans, has a history of underperforming after losing a big game. I'll be looking to see if this team plays with the same confidence we saw for them in the first half of the year. Then there's the Gladiators. They're a team that continues to be on the rise for me. Their roster is full of potential, and I only see them improving even more as Roar and Decay continue to become more comfortable with their English. Because they do possess a potential danger factor, that leads me to believe that perhaps they could do some damage to Vancouver. However, as of right now, I still find it hard to believe that anybody but the Shock could take them down. Until I'm proved wrong, I am picking the Titans to win 4-0. If the Gladiators can't even take a map off of the NYXL, then it's tough to see them doing it against an even stronger team. I think the Titans aren't going to let their shortcomings get to them here. Their loss against the Shock is going to make them extra motivated to play well, I feel like. I do believe that this game could end up being closer than the score implies, but I do predict that Vancouver remains in firm control for a majority of the match. And with that being said, that is going to wrap up my key matches for Week 1 of Stage 3. What matches do you think are the most exciting? Make sure to let me know down in the comment section, and feel free to let me know if you think I left out any important games. If you enjoyed today's content, then be sure to like and subscribe. As always, thank you all so much for watching, and until next time, this is ATP, signing out. Peace.